You're on with Elvis Duran and the Z100 Morning Show. Z100.
New York City weather, mostly sunny today, becoming less humid as we go through the afternoon. High around 90 degrees. Tonight, down to 75. And then tomorrow, could see some rain in there. High 86. Right now, 78 at Z100.
Get into it. Dear Elvis, my boyfriend Justin loves two things in life. Me and working out at the gym.
Oh.
Let's phone tap him when he gets out of his workout and see if we can stir up some trouble. All right. So when a guy is taking his time at the gym very seriously, when he gets off the workout, he wants to breathe it down.
Yes.
You don't want to mess with him. All right. Well, Leanne starts the call to her boyfriend Justin, who we're phone tapping. Calling him from the library. Garrett joins in as the guy trying to get some work done at the library, and let's see how all these moving parts work together in today's phone tap. Let's listen in.
Hello?
Hi, honey.
Hey, what's going on?
Nothing. What are you doing?
I'm just finishing up a workout at the gym.
Yeah. I'm at the library.
Oh,
so,
okay.
Yeah, I'm like in the back
Shh. Okay, I gotcha.
Excuse me. Shh. Can you just keep it down for a minute? I'm trying to finish up a paper over here. I would appreciate that, so thank you.
Okay. Sorry.
What was that? Anyway.
I don't know, some guy. So you know how Katie is getting married?
Yeah.
Remember I told you and I'm going to be in the wedding and everything?
Excuse me. Can you at least take the conversation outside while I finish?
Okay, but this is my conversation, so, like, you know, maybe you could just move.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay? I didn't.
Anyway.
Okay. All right.
So we're at the store, right?
Shh.
And,
Hey, step outside so others can finish their work in the library. That's where we
are.
Everything all right?
Yeah, this is a jerk over here.
I'm going to have to ask you to hang up the phone.
I'm going to have to ask you to shut up.
Shush.
What's going on?
Some guy is just, like, telling me to be quiet.
Give me that. Hello? Who's this?
Hello?
Yeah,
who is this?
I don't know. That's why I'm asking.
What are you doing?
She's acting very loud in the library.
Mind your business before I come over there and break your legs, all right?
I can't mind my business because she is so loud over here going,
Why don't you go study some more? Put your face back in the book.
I am trying to, but I have a high-pitched screech in my ear from your girlfriend talking so loud. I don't know if she knows any public manners, but maybe you should teach her.
You know what? Don't even start there, all right? Don't even talk to her like that.
I'm talking to you like that because
you... Well, don't talk to me like that. You're disrespecting me and her.
You're disrespecting the sanctuary of this library, okay? I'm trying to get some work...
Go put your face in the book before I put it in there for you, all right?
Don't get violent with me, okay? I've read up on guys like you, and I know how to take you down.
What does it say?
Okay, let me open up the thesaurus to douchebag, okay?
Hey,
and has your picture under it.
Wait till I get out of the gym. I'm coming right there. How long are you going to be there? Are you going to be there all day?
I live in this place, okay? This is like my bat cave, okay?
Wait till I get there.
I need you and your obnoxious little girlfriend to take your business elsewhere.
Watch your mouth.
All right?
Don't say another word until I get there, and then say it to my face when I get there.
I don't come to your gym and start grunting in front of you. That's what your girlfriend's basically doing to me in my sanctuary of this library.
You don't have any idea who you're talking to right now.
Have you ever been smacked in the head with a World Book Encyclopedia? Because I'm about to.
Is that what you're going to do? Make that promise to me right now. Make that promise to me.
You might be Mr. I go to a gym, but I lift almanacs all day. You don't know how heavy those are.
I don't care if you lift cement trucks. Wait till I get there with all my buddies. You're not going to have one word to say to me. You're going to be hiding. Don't even try to call campus security.
Keep
talking. I dare you. Keep talking.
You know what? If you're going to come in, at least respect
me. You need to respect Leanne. You need to respect me. You're on the phone with someone you don't even know who this is.
You don't even know who you're messing with over here at the library.
See what's going to happen. Keep running your mouth. Just wait.
Okay, I am going to step aside and get a breath of fresh air as I prepare for your ass to be kicked.
Whose ass are you going to kick? I bet you've never kicked anyone's ass in your life. You've probably never been in a fight.
I'm going to give you back the phone to your obnoxious little girlfriend.
Whose ass are you
going to
kick?
Here's your D-bag boyfriend. All right.
Shut up. Yeah, he's not going to shush you anymore.
He said that I was obnoxious.
I'm calling my buddies. We're on our way. I just left the gym. You already know I'm pumped up. I'm ready to go.
Oh, my
Justin,
gosh.
You just got phone tapped.
Excuse me?
My name's Garrett from Elvis Duran in the Morning Show, your girlfriend Leanne wanted to play a joke on you, my friend.
Oh, my God. I'm on my way to the library right now. I can tell you that much.
The Elvis Duran phone tap.
Who do you stand up for? Well, MasterCard is collaborating with Stand Up to Cancer and invites you to join in the fight against cancer on July 16th. Go to priceless.com/SU2C to find out how you can support.
Our iHeartRadio Music Festival, presented by Capital One.
Coming back to Las Vegas.
September 20th and 21st, streaming live only on Hulu.
Just added to the superstar lineup.
Dua Lipa and Halsey, sharing the iHeart stage with Big Sean.
I live the life I deserve.
Camila Cabello, Doja Cat, Gwen Stefani, Hozier, Keith Urban, New Kids on the Block, Paramore, Shaboozy, The Black Crows, Thomas Rhett, Victoria Monet.
Power 2024 iHeartRadio Music Festival. Presented by Capital One.
Tickets are on sale now at AXS.com. That's AXS.com.
Hey, pool season fanatics, your summer persona is calling. It's time for sun-soaked party scenes at MGM Grand. New luxury cabanas at Bellagio. And sandy beach living at Mandalay Bay. Show off your poolside only with MGM Rewards. Visit MGMRewards.com for details.
The funniest movie of the summer is Despicable Me 4. Rated PG. Parental guidance suggested. In theaters now.
Having trouble sleeping? It could be your mattress. Right now, at PC Richard & Son, save on Tempur-Pedic and Stearns & Foster adjustable mattress sets. And get up to $300 cash back, good towards any other same-day purchase. Only at PC Richard & Son.
What if there was an internet plan, not just made for you, but made by you, where you choose what's in your plan and only pay for what you want? Introducing My Home from Verizon. Plans start at just $35 a month with auto pay and select 5G mobile plans. Welcome to internet your way. Call 1-800-VERIZON and switch today. 5G Home, LTE Home, and Fios internet plans each start at $35 per month when combined with select mobile unlimited plans. Availability varies. Auto pay and paper-free billing required. Subject to credit approval. Fios Mobile Plus Home discount requires enrollment and $99 setup. Additional terms apply.
Great Scott! Back to the Future is now on Broadway, and audiences are going wild, declares the New York Times. It's a jaw-dropping spectacle that hits all the right buttons, hails USA Today. And the Hollywood Reporter raves, it's damn fun, and sends the crowd out on a massive high. Back to the Future, the musical. When this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're going to see some serious entertainment. Get your tickets now at backtothefuturemusical.com.
Fanatics Fest NYC is coming to the Javits Center August 16th through the 18th. It's the largest sports card and collectible show to ever happen in New York City. See Derek Jeter, Tom Brady, Peyton and Eli Manning, Kevin Durant, and hundreds of more athletes and attractions. Visit fanaticsfest.com to buy tickets now.
Truth, beauty, freedom, love. Celebrate the 5th anniversary of Moulin Rouge the Musical on Broadway this summer. The Bohemian Summer. Moulin Rouge the Musical is the winner of 10 Tony Awards, including Best Musical. And it's so easy to see why. From the moment you step into the theater, you know you're going to have a fabulous experience. Moulin Rouge the Musical. It's a beautiful love story, drama, comedy, music, dance. The most stunning show on Broadway. Visit MoulinRougeMusical.com for tickets and info.
WHTZ FM and HD2.
Newark.
New York City.
Z100.
An iHeartRadio station. The exclusive audio home of NBC's coverage of the 2024 Paris Olympics.
We are back. It is season 2 of your favorite New Girl Rewatch podcast. We have got a new season. We got a new name. We've got some of your favorite people from the New Girl universe. We've got the creator and showrunner, Liz Merriweather. We got the Max Greenfield.
We also have some of your least favorites, like Jake Johnson.
Lamorne.
Hannah, what's up?
We do have Jake Johnson, though.
Yeah. Listen to The Mess Around on America's number one podcast network, iHeart. Open your free iHeart app and search The Mess Around and start listening.
Duncan, traffic.
Just hit a snag if you're heading for the inbound side of the Gowanus. There's a crash by Fort Hamilton Parkway, exit 18, and it's in the center lane. So some very heavy delays as you travel through Bay Ridge. Meantime, on the Jackie Robinson Parkway, that's going to be closed in both directions, all because of a vehicle fire. So you're going to be jammed both ways into Union Turnpike, especially busy on the westbound side, about a 45-minute delay. Westbound Cross Bronx still had this broken-down box truck. It is going to be on the Alex along the right side of the roadway. Heading for the northbound Henrietson Parkway, it's a crash by the George Washington Bridge. This report is sponsored by Mattress Firm. Summer's best deals are still going at Mattress Firm. The July 4th sale has been extended. Right now, you can save up to $700 when you get a king bed at queen prices. Get matched with a wide selection of mattresses at every price. Restrictions apply. I'm Bernie Viter with Total Traffic on Z100.
Elvis Duran and the Z100 Morning Show.
Z100.
I don't wanna tiptoe, but I don't
pretend. You cling to your papers and pens. Wait until you like me again. Wait for your love.
Thursday, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Like, I have to tell you something real quick. Just ahead of the huge Summer Bash announcement. I met our friend Darren Pfeffer for lunch at the bar yesterday in Livingston, New Jersey, at this institution called Nemo's Grill. Nemo's has been there for, since the 60s, 1960s.
Wow.
Anyway, it was great. Sat at the bar, and Chris, the bartender, who's always there, was great. And Dan, the manager who runs the place, and Janine, one of our favorite servers there. Anyway, the whole gang was there. So I heard this podcast where they say every Thursday night at Nemo's Grill in Livingston, it's like pineapple night.
Oh.
You know what that means, right?
Swingers?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
People show up. Oh. It's like Thursday nights are huge. And if you're from the Livingston, New Jersey area, I guess you know what I'm talking about. I'm thinking tonight may be my lucky night.
Hey.
Nate, come to Nemo's tonight for Pineapple Swingers Night with me.
Oh, I can't wait.
I know, it's going to be awesome.
Are you buying the pineapple or am I?
It's just a figure.
I'll bring my Adirondack chair.
Yeah, that's another one.
Yeah.
Anyway, so I just love it. It's become a thing.
Yeah.
And I just blew the lid off this top secret thing that only Livingston, New Jerseyites wanted us to know or didn't want us to know.
That's not the same thing as throwing your keys in the bowl and then you're like, you pick a key and you have to go home with the person that's key you got.
It's Nero's. But did I say Nemo's?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm thinking Nero's. Of the animated fish.
I was going to say
Nemo. No, it's Nero's. Now, I went to Nero's years ago, back in the 1980s. So Nero's Grill with, like I said, Janine and Chris the bartender and Dan. Nero's.
Yeah.
Fabulous. Anyway, yeah, Frog, what's up?
Did you know that Pennsylvania is the number one state for swingers? New York is number two.
Wow.
What's going on in Pennsylvania?
New Jersey's number five.
Number five. Well, thanks to Nero's, we're going to bring it up to number one. Tonight's the night, baby.
Tonight.
Anyway, look, my writing. The R looks like an M.
Yeah. Darren, DFF just texted. Please tell him it's Nero's. And yeah,
I got it. It's Nero's. Okay. Oh, my God. Anyway, so if you're a crazy swinger, tonight's the night. Thursday night's at Nero's. Mm-hmm. Got to go. Why was I thinking Nemo? I was thinking of the stupid, you're going to Disneyland.
Maybe, yeah, whatever. For the fish.
Yeah.
Did you just call Nemo stupid?
Yeah.
No, I didn't mean, oh God, now I'm dead now.
How dare you?
Hey, is Emmett here?
He's here, but we,
Yeah, I know we have stuff to do. But it was a yes or no question.
He is, he's pottying, and then they're prepping pizzas.
Okay, good.
So, yeah,
wait till you meet Emmett, the coolest guy known to man. All right, it's now time for the big announcement. Let's pretend like it's exclusive information. Every summer, we gather at Hudson Yards for a nighttime concert to celebrate music and summer. This year's Z100 Summer Bash, Hudson Yards, Thursday, August 8th. It's from 6 to 9. And the Morse code's telling us it's totally free. Totally free!
Yeah!
It's gonna be a big,
complimentary.
It's going to be a big show this year.
I thought you didn't like the word free. You liked complimentary.
It's complimentary. Yeah, the word free is so cheap and tawdry.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
This year, we give you at Z100 Summer Bash at Hudson Yards, Thursday, August 8th, 6 to 9, totally free. Teddy Swims is going to be there.
Amazing!
I know.
I love Teddy Swims.
We love Teddy Swims. Bia is going to be there. Mm-hmm. Excellent artist. Shaboozy!
Yes! Yeah.
Shaboozy's going to be there.
It's gonna be
also,
massive.
Mark Amber, Alex Warren, who has a huge following as well. It's going to be quite the night.
It's going to be so fun.
Absolutely. So again, it is Z100 Summer Bash, Hudson Yards. It's Thursday, August 8th. We'll all be there as well.
Yeah.
It's 6 to 9 p.m. and it is free. This is another thing we love about big, festive, cool areas like Hudson Yards. In New York City, we can have free events. So no matter where you are on this planet or in this galaxy, you can be a part of it and just show up. You can go to Z100.com. All the info is there. It's been there all night. So there you go. So again, the big announcement, we'll see you at Z100 Summer Bash. All the info, like I said, at Z100.com. Is this Teddy Swims?
Yes.
Oh, there he is. I bet he sings this.
I bet he does.
Another reason you listen to Z100. It's fantastic.
I took a page out of your favorite book. You saw me last. Just a man.
He is so cool.
Yeah.
Teddy Swims. The Door. He will perform that at Z100's Summer Bash. August 8th. It's a Thursday night at Hudson Yards. It's totally free to get in. How do we pull that off?
I don't know.
I know. I have an idea.
Mm-hmm.
Let's put up a gate and start charging admission.
Great idea.
We'd make so much money.
And Scary, do that fake valet parking and steal their cars. Steal their cars. We'll take fake admission. Teddy Swims, Bia, Shaboozy, Mark Amber, and Alex Warren. All of us will be there. You'll be there, too. All the information at Z100.com. All right. Let's get into the three things we need to know from Gandhi. Our friend Emmett is here. He's getting the pizza ready.
Nice.
And his great story. We got to talk about pizza. Because, you know, we're living right in the heart of pizza land.
Yeah.
So we think he may try to talk us out of that.
Mm.
We'll see. All right, what's going on?
Okay. The IRS says it has collected more than $1 billion in past due taxes from millionaires since last fall. The announcement made today was credited to funds provided by the Inflation Reduction Act passed by Congress nearly 2 years ago. IRS Commissioner Danny Werfel says that while the agency clearly knew the taxes were owed, they simply hadn't had the staffing or resources to go after all of the wealthy individuals, but they say that they're doing it now. Elon Musk says his brain tech startup Neuralink is just about ready for its second patient. The first ever patient, paralyzed from the shoulders down, received an implant last winter. There have been some noted technical issues, but the device still allows him to perform activities like playing chess and video games. Elon Musk announced Wednesday that they hope to implant the Neuralink system in a second human patient within the next week or so. And finally, Team USA took Canada out 86-72 in exhibition basketball play leading up to the Paris Olympics that are happening later this month. Are you guys big Olympics fans?
Yes.
Yeah, you know what?
I love the Olympics.
And you're already hearing the stories about the people who are competing.
Mm-hmm.
But during the Olympics.
Oh, yeah. So exciting.
You learn more about other athletes. I can't wait.
It's just fascinating. They put everything into this one moment.
Yep.
I love it. Anyway, Team USA will now face Australia on Monday in Abu Dhabi. Team USA is 5-0 in exhibition games against the Canadians since 1999. And those are your three things.
Excellent. So, you want some pizza?
Yes. Yes.
And I know you're sitting there in the car going, well, they're eating pizza. What is in this for me? Every pizza has a story. And Emmett's going to tell his coming up.
The Mercedes-Benz Interview Lounge.
Lenny Kravitz, you and I are about the same age. I don't know why you look so great. I look like hammered.
He was going to ask you what your secret is.
He dropped it earlier. He had water, and we're taking shots of Nutella.
I want to hang out with you guys.
What makes a Mercedes-Benz EV different? Electric is what gets you there, but Mercedes is what moves you. Like no other automaker can. The vehicles are all electric. The feeling is all Mercedes. The choice is all yours. Learn more at mbusa.com/EQ.
Elvis Duran in the Morning Show.
Who do you stand up for? Well, MasterCard is collaborating with Stand Up to Cancer and invites you to join in the fight against cancer on July 16th. Go to priceless.com/SU2C to find out how you can support. So we just announced it. The big announcement. Z100's Summer Bash, Hudson Yards, Thursday, August 8th, 6 to 9 p.m. It's free. This bash has been getting bigger and bigger every year, and now it's massive, and it's free to see Teddy Swims and Bia, Shaboozy, Mark Amber, Alex Warren, and us.
Woo!
So it's totally free, but if you call now, we'll get you in for free.
What?
No. We'll give you VIP tickets.
Oh, okay.
Like cut the line, get to the best part of the show tickets.
Oh.
Be called at 100, 1-800-242-0100.
It's almost here. Team USA is headed to Paris, and iHeartRadio is the exclusive audio home of NBC's coverage of the 2024 Paris Olympics. It's the only way to listen to exclusive NBC play-by-play action of the games, plus NBC's top Olympic moments and live hourly updates from Paris. Bring the summer games with you everywhere you go. Download the free iHeart app now and enable push notifications for live updates from Paris. Only on iHeartRadio, the exclusive audio home of NBC's coverage of the 2024 Paris Olympics.
The funniest movie of the summer is Despicable Me 4. Rated PG. Parental guidance suggested. In theaters now.
Prime Day is just a few days away, but you can start saving now on DeLonghi's Magnifica Evo or La Specialista Arte Evo with up to $250 off. DeLonghi has an espresso machine just for you. Visit DeLonghi.com and shop for summer savings now until July 20th.
Choice is a good thing. Like what movie to stream tonight?
Want to watch a comedy?
Superheroes!
Mystery!
And now, with My Home from Verizon, you can finally choose what's in your internet plan and save big on the entertainment you love, like Netflix and Max for just $10 a month. Call 1-800-VERIZON and switch today. Netflix and Max with ads perk requires an eligible Verizon Home Internet VHI plan. Must be 18 years or older. Cancel anytime. One offer per eligible VHI account. Additional terms apply. Max and related elements are property of Homebox Office Incorporated.
Hey, it's Maxwell, and it's been a little more than a year since I went to De La Russo to get my vision right. And I have to tell you, life changing. In 24 hours, you too can see better than ever. Just call De La Russo Laser Vision. Get rid of those glasses, no more contacts, no more touching your eyeballs. Ugh. They offer the safest, most up-to-date technology, and they also offer a 24-month and interest-free payment option. Plus, De La Russo's newest location is now open in Westport, Connecticut. So give them a call at 855-646-2020 or online at delarusso.com.
Great Scott! Back to the Future is now on Broadway, and it's a jaw-dropping spectacle, rates USA Today. When this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're going to see some serious entertainment. Visit backtothefuturemusical.com and get your tickets yesterday.
Hey, country music fans! Luke Combs is coming to town, and when you visit your local T-Mobile store, you can enter for your chance to win two tickets to one of Luke's shows and a meet-and-greet with a country music superstar. Head to www.tmobile.com/LukeSweeps to find a participating T-Mobile store near you. Don't miss out. Open to 50 U.S. DC PR 18 plus residents. See store for full rules and entry form. Void where prohibited.
Moulin Rouge, the musical, is celebrating its fifth year on Broadway. This show has everything. It's a beautiful love story, drama, comedy, music, dance. The most stunning show on Broadway. It has 70 songs remixed in the most ingenious ways from your favorites from the iconic movie, including Elton John and Lady Marmalade, and newer songs from Adele and Beyonce, Sia, and so many more. They're calling this their Bohemian Summer, and if you haven't seen it, make your summer spectacular. Visit MoulinRougeMusical.com for tickets and info.
Introducing Sparked Energy by Dunkin', available in two flavors, Berry Burst and Peach Sunshine. Order ahead on the app and get a medium Sparked Energy for $3 in July. Fruit flavored, contains 0% fruit juice, caffeine from guarana and caffeine. Participation may vary, limited time offer, terms apply.
Duncan, traffic.
It is really crawling heading through Nassau County. Eastbound Southern State, a crash by Grand Avenue, exit 20. Two left lanes are blocked off, hardly moving back from Hempstead Avenue. And if you're on the westbound side, expect delays as well into Grand Avenue. Still shut on the Jackie Robinson Parkway westbound by Union Turnpike. That is a vehicle fire. The eastbound side has been reopened. And you got this box truck that stalled out on the westbound Cross Bronx on the Alex. The right lane is blocked off. That's been there for a couple of hours at this point. This report is sponsored by the BMW Summer Sales event now through July 31st. Lease a 2024 BMW i4 eDrive 35 for $449 per month for 36 months with $4,869 due at signing and zero security deposit. Government and dealer fees not included. Details at tristatebmw.com. I'm Bernie Viter with Total Traffic on Z100.
Oh, it's my escape.
You're so funny.
Yeah. Got me feeling this way.
Yeah, I mean, we grew up like
Elvis Duran
junkies, so we love it.
Elvis Duran and the Z100 Morning Show.
Sunny, becoming less humid through the day. High around 89, then tonight down to 75 degrees. Tomorrow, sunny, humid. So could see some showers in there in the afternoon. High 86. Right now, 78 at Z100.
It can't be said I'm a worthy bird. It's 10 o'clock before I say a word. Baby, I can never tell.
go.
Elvis Duran and the Morning Show.
You know it's a special morning when Gandhi takes her Invisalign out.
I did. I took my teeth out just for you guys. I'm so excited. Did.
So, it wasn't that long ago. A friend of mine said, hey, let's go out for pizza.
I said, okay.
This place on McDougal in the village. It's called Emmett's. Let's go. I went, okay. Mm-hmm. They have like, you know, it could be Chicago style. We're not sure. I don't know. I don't know. Let's just go. We did. Wow. Now, how many times have I come in here and say, oh my God, Emmett's?
All the time.
And it's hard to say what your favorite pizza in New York City is because there are so many great pizzas. Even Emmett would agree. Emmett, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
And you know what? I told you he's a really cool guy with a great mustache. He shaved off the mustache.
That's the first thing you said to him when you saw him. Where's your mustache?
Yeah, we should have put that in the notes, you know?
I don't know. Pre-production.
Yeah. Anyway, hot girls and mustache.
This is it. Yeah. And so Emmett's, of course, originally on McDougal, and then Emmett's on Grove is the big one now. It's hard to get in. I mean, people are loving the party that's going on there every night.
It's a fun place.
It is. At Christmas time, they actually take tables out and put this big-ass Christmas tree up.
Oh, that's love nice.
And it's just great. Okay, but let's talk about pizza. Here we are in New York City eating pizza from a guy who was originally from...
Chicago.
Okay. So you would think, well, this guy's all deep dish. No, you know, we got to cut slack for Chicago. They also have this very thin crust tavern style pie, which is what we're eating today.
Yeah. And we all have piles of pizza on our plates.
Piles of it. Mm-hmm. So talk about it. You're from Chicago, but you came to New York. What did you see in New York that was missing that you wanted to bring to the city?
Well, I grew up delivering pizzas in Chicago.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I think I like pizza as much as anyone likes pizza, right? Everyone loves pizza. But delivering pizzas, love pizza, got to school in New York, and I found out they didn't have Chicago-style pizza. And I thought that was crazy because you walk around and you can see, you know, cuisine and types of food from countries that are I've never even heard of.
Right.
And for some reason, Chicago-style pizza was never, you know, really represented. So I came up with the idea. I said, you know, maybe one day I'll open up like a Chicago-style pizza. And for a sophomore year marketing class, I was supposed to design a company, and I called it Emmett's LSD. It was Emmett's Lakeshore Dive, and it was just a Chicago-style pizza place.
Right.
Just like you walked into McDougal. So.
Did anyone try to talk you out of it? Go, dude, it's in New York City.
People are still trying to talk me out of it.
I mean, was there resistance from anyone?
Yeah. I mean, I don't know if you guys have ever seen that rant that Jon Stewart went on about deep dish pizza. You called it like a casserole.
Right. And, come closer.
Yeah, called it like a casserole. And,
yes, he
and,
did.
That was the week that we opened.
Perfect.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
So it was like very
better,
fortuitous. Yeah.
That was awesome.
It was amazing, right? So, you know, so all of a sudden people in New York really wanted to see what Chicago style pizza was all about. And it was like, you know, amazing.
Look at that.
Wow.
Yeah.
And so our favorites, the hot girl and the hot poppy, which I'm enjoying now. Which one is it? This is the hot...
That's the poppy's got the ranch.
Mm-hmm.
And the hot girl is, you know, it's got my... You got to plug Mike's hot honey. So the hot girl's got jalapeno, pepperoni, and Mike's hot honey on it. So
I can't wait.
We were talking about Mike.
You can eat on air, right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
But people with that
mesophonia.
Mesophonia.
If
they hear you chewing food, they get very upset. Yeah. Our apologies to those who have misophonia or whatever.
Yeah, whatever it's called.
So, we were talking about Mike from Mike's Hot Honey yesterday. On this show, we interview every big artist known to man. Name them, we've interviewed them. So, we get excited to meet them and everything. But when I had a chance to meet Mike from Mike's Hot Honey, my palms got sweaty.
I remember that.
I got moist. I was like, whoa.
Yeah.
He's a celebrity to me, as you are a celebrity to us. Is that weird?
Hey, you know, everyone likes pizza, so I appreciate it.
Okay. All right. Scary. You're the old Brooklyn guy.
Yeah.
I mean, what are you thinking? What have you had so far?
I ate a hot girl. And
that does not sound right.
I'm talking about the pizza.
You know, hot girl slice. The hot honey on it is phenomenal, and the jalapenos. I just needed a little extra water, but it's so good. I got to say, the thin crust. I'm a thin crust guy. I don't like flop. So this, biting into this and feeling that crunch and going, that is everything to me.
Well, doesn't the ranch kind of turn down the heat a little bit?
It balances it out. But you know the perfect balance is a martini. So that's the one thing I forgot.
Oh, damn it to hell.
Should have done martinis.
You got to come back tomorrow.
Talk about going off the rails.
Roni cups. The Roni cups are just
Okay. Here, go get me one of those.
Yeah, you want one?
Yeah, get me something. Yeah, with Mike's Hot Honey on it.
Go. Oh, wait, here, have some of this. I think I've piled my plate too high.
No, no, okay. Hey, Josh. So, Josh, in the other room, the guy who looks like he's was up all night doing a bender, he and I went to...
Me too, Josh. I'm right with you.
We were at McDougal twice with each other. Right, look, he's a huge pizza freak. We're just huge fans. Huge
Josh
fans.
Came in early today just for this, I think.
Yeah, usually, I knew I liked him.
Usually he's still curled up under a bus stop somewhere at this hour. So let's talk about pizza. Let's talk about people who feel like their pizza is the best. And I'm sure, like, we have New Haven listening right now. We have people across the country digitally listening, you know, in Chicago, of course. And but once someone said, wow, the best pizza I had was this place in L.A. And I went, no, it can't be. We got to open our minds. It's not a city thing. It's a who does it thing. It's not a Brooklyn water thing that makes the dough different, or is it?
I don't think so. I think, you know, everyone kind of wants to protect, you know.
Thank you, Scary.
He brought the whole pizza.
Protect their product. You know, Italians are going to say you can only get good cappuccino in Italy because of our water, and of course they just want you to come to Italy and drink cappuccino.
I got that. So, all right. All right. I don't know. I love it all. Mm.
Has this changed your life as far as consuming pizza from other places?
You know, I eat so much pizza, so I love it. You know, it's I'm trying to cut back on pizza a little bit, you know, but I was, you know, I would say for about 10 years since we opened, I was eating pizza every day. And, you know, I eat it from, you know, I have a lot of friends who have pizzerias. So, you know, if I'm not eating at my place, I'm eating at other spots. And,
so you guys are friendly with each other? It's not like a cutthroat? We're pizza people.
I would say it's a little clicky. You know, there's you know, people have their, you know, alliances and stuff like that. But, you know, for the most part, you know, there's a lot of mutual respect.
There's no pizza wars?
Oh, there's some pizza wars.
Oh, yeah.
You see these pepperoni cups?
Yeah.
There's a big pizza war in New York. It's very famous because of those things.
Really?
I'll tell you off the air.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, Nate, what are you eating down there? How do you turn him on? I don't understand how to work this thing.
All right, go to the tip.
Yeah, no, you're on. Okay, wherever you are. What are you eating?
I'm eating the hot girl. My God. Okay. So good.
You both wish.
That's how you turn them on.
So you could have named these pizzas anything. Why hot girl, hot poppy? And also at McDougal, there's like a Uncle Gay Al or something.
Big Gay Al.
Big Gay Al.
Yeah. Okay,
where do these stories come? Obviously, they're made based on some story, I'm assuming.
Yeah. They're just kind of fun names. I think with like the hot poppy, you know, it had jalapeno and it had these things. And it's just like, you know, how do you kind of capture the essence of something? And I was just like, oh, it's called the hot poppy.
But
and
a hot girl, though.
The hot girl, that was, when was the hot girl summer? Was that two summers ago?
I don't know.
Maybe four. A few.
Four.
Yep, four?
Yeah. So
pandemic summer.
Okay. Yeah, yeah. So that was that summer. And, you know, we were, you know, good friends with Mike, you know, love his product, and I was like, you know, I want to put hot honey on a pizza, you know, what are we going to do? And it's like, well, we have the hot poppy, why don't we do something like, you know, a lot of the names, we have Big Gal, but we also have, you know, Nadine and, you know, the Peggy O and some other ones that are kind of more feminine. We have the Mona Lisa. I'm like, you know, I think you know, we need to show some girls some love, so it was the hot girl.
Okay. Yeah. No, but who's Big Gal? Is there a real guy, Al?
Big Al, that's a reference to a South Park episode. He was like a character in South Park.
That's right. Yeah.
That's
oh my God.
Right.
So, and the funny thing is there's an Italian beef stand in Chicago called Al's Beef.
Right.
So it's kind of a play on both of them.
So it's Italian beef.
Yeah.
Wow.
Italian beef and jardiniere, which is a big seller for us.
So you know what jardiniere is, right?
Oh, it's amazing.
It's peppers. It's, yeah. What can you explain it?
It's like pickled peppers, right? So it's, you know, in Chicago, it's, you know, it's kind of like everything they kind of derived from this age where they had to kind of, you know, make sure that their pickles and their vegetables and everything kind of lasted, and they just kind of sprinkle it on, and it gives a nice little spice and kick, you know. But it's really a sacred thing in Chicago.
So a text, whenever we visit New York City, Emmett's is a must for us. I'm pregnant. We have a son named Emmett. Wow.
Wow.
All right.
She didn't say if that was your son or not. I don't know. I don't know. I'm not asking questions.
I love how he doesn't say anything. He's like,
could be.
So have you been to Naples? Have you eaten the pizza there? Because they say that's the birthplace of pizza.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. But a lot of places claim that, you know.
But I feel like we own it now. I feel like we kind of stole it from them, even though.
Like me and you?
Well, not you and me, but I feel like America has made it an American thing.
Yeah.
Even though Napoli is...
Yeah. I mean, I think a lot of people say that it started in Greece, and, you know, you hear different, you know, and especially, like, you know, I'm on these, like, you know, pizza chains and stuff like that, so there's all these debates, so, you know.
So, question. So, this is from Emmett's. Or you go to any of the great pizza places in New York City, you get pizza. Are there any, like, frozen pizzas that actually are, in your opinion, like, wow, okay. this is actually okay.
Well, Emmett does a frozen pizza.
Oh, here we go. I didn't know this. Let me write this down.
Yeah.
Do you get it at Emmett's or can I get it at like a store?
Like a Gold Belly thing?
You can do both. Yeah, it's a Gold Belly thing and you can get it you know, in the shop. So it's they're nice door prizes, you know.
Has Portnoy...
Someone has to wait for a table. He says, you know what, here's a frozen pizza.
Oh, has David Portnoy ever come and done his pizza review?
He has, yeah. He came to the original one and he reviewed the deep dish pizza.
And what did he say?
He liked it. Yeah, he liked it. So it was...
You know, just one bite. That's all he does.
Yeah.
And then he eats the whole slice.
Yeah, then he eats the whole slice, yeah. Yeah.
So Image says that really deep dish is a once or twice a year thing. But this tavern pizza, you could eat this almost every other day.
I think you do every day.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
All right. So is there a pizza you... Is there such thing as a bad pizza? Like a bad slice? And if so, what... No names needed, but what makes a bad slice in your opinion?
I mean, I think it's, you know, what makes like a bad song. It's just someone that doesn't really know what they're doing or really care what they're doing. You know, I mean, I think with pizza, there's really three components, right? Dough, sauce, and cheese, right? So I think as long as you care a little bit about all these things, like I've had pizza, like, you know, I was in on vacation, I won't even say where, last week, and we walked in this place and it was just this old grimy bar and, you know, the pizza was reheated and I'm like, you know, even bad pizza's pretty good.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. That's my point. Yeah. I rarely met a bad pizza, even though some are better than others.
You don't ever throw pizza out the bed.
Nah.
No.
Yeah. Not at all. And I have pizza in my bed all the time.
Yeah.
So what about ham and pineapple? Go.
Hey. I'm all for it. You know, we have a pizza called the Magnum PI. So it's a Hawaiian pizza with ham and and pineapple.
Wow.
So,
yeah. Delicious.
Yeah.
I've never had
olives,
one of these.
Green olives and peppers.
I draw the line there.
Why?
No, I'm kidding.
What about black olives?
We like black olives too. Yeah.
See, what were you saying?
I've never had the pineapple pizza.
Okay.
Does it have red sauce on it and then the pineapple? Or is
there
no?
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah.
It is good. It's really good.
All right, Josh.
I don't know about this. Okay.
Let's do it.
I go there for all my hangovers, honestly.
So you're there every day?
I usually leave there and have a hangover the next day.
Yeah, I was going to say, you go there to get them or hear them?
To continue them.
Yeah.
But the one time you took me, that's the first time I went. And we did this thing where we each order our pie separately, or secretly.
Yes.
We told the waiter.
Wow. We had secret pies.
And then mine was the pineapple one with bacon and caramelized onions. And I get it every time I go now. I've never been a pineapple pizza guy, but Emmett's changed my life in that way.
Mine is the sausage, mushroom, caramelized onion, and black olive.
Caramelized onion on pizza, but then is so good.
And I have to get the sauce. Is it, you called it your official ranch sauce, right? Or is it just
It's a paprika ranch.
The paprika ranch.
Yeah.
What? Can I ask you a question? The cheese has such an interesting texture. Like, it doesn't seem like it's like normal cheese. Is that?
We have our own cows, and we, you know, massage them.
New York City cows. That's the secret.
I love the cheese. I don't know. There's something about their cheese there.
No, we do. We are pretty... we are pretty deliberate with, you know, what we use and things like that. And it makes a difference. Like I said, you know, if you really care about the integrity of the ingredients that you're using, it makes a big difference. So the cheese is, and that's the first thing you bite into, right? So.
Yeah,
it is.
Yeah.
What's the cheese? It's from St. Louis. Starts with a P.
Provel.
Provel.
Provel cheese.
But you don't use that, do you?
No.
Okay.
No, that's a St. Louis thing, so.
Okay. All right. Sorry. Chicago guy in New York.
Yeah.
It's okay. You can use whatever you want.
No.
What were you going to say?
You read my mind. That's exactly where I was going. Because I was at a pizza fest once, and they were like, we're from St. Louis. And they said, you could only get this here in St. Louis, this Provel cheese. It's got a very distinct taste.
It does.
I got to say, it was amazing. So I was like, you going to ever do one of those?
You know, we won't. We'll leave that in St. Louis.
Wow. There's some deep personal... There's some angst and hurt here.
You know, it's just not my vibe.
Okay. It's good.
We'll leave it there.
All right. So anywhere in America, there's a place to get pizza.
Yeah.
And people are listening to us all across the country.
Yeah.
So I guess it's fair for us to celebrate pizza no matter where it's from. Even St. Louis, Emmett.
Yeah.
We should thank them for doing that great job that they do. And pizza. I want everyone listening to the sound of our voices to go out and get pizza today.
Mm.
We prefer you get it at Emmett's.
Yeah, I was going to say, you should go to Emmett's.
Okay, of course you should.
I just like that we've talked so long about pizza.
Well, what else you want to talk about?
Nothing.
You want to talk to Emmett about his black limousine?
You have it? Still?
Oh, yeah, we still have it, yeah. Emmett's 3.
You
I think
drive
the next
it
interview we do... yeah, that's the real party.
Wait, what do you do with the limo? Just to...
Watch movies, drink champagne.
So do you drive around in it, or do you give it to people to drive? You know, do you pick people up?
We pick people up so you can deliver pizzas in it. And I have this like collection of like 80s VHS tapes and we'll watch it in the back. And
wow.
I can show you. It's pretty fun.
Where do you even park a limo in New York?
Right in front of Grove. So
okay.
And you know,
it's a statement.
Okay. There's actually a film out, and they named a pizza after it, and it's on those VHS tapes. It's called Packin' Poppy.
Is really? Name,
yeah, have you seen that video?
No.
No. Yeah. Is that like a...
It's total bounce. Well, yeah, bounce.
Okay.
There it is. Look at that.
Oh.
So.
He's pimping around New York City.
So I just like to watch these, you know, old music videos. Oh,
yeah, it's so cute. You like watching old videos in the back seat.
It's like a time machine.
He's a weird dude, man. We love Emmett.
I have friends in the back, too. You know.
Of course you do.
I'm sure you do.
So, Josh, any final thoughts for Emmett?
I just want to go in this limo.
Of course
oh
you do.
Oh, my gosh. Of course you do.
Can we get in this thing? Let's have, like, a pizza party for my birthday coming up.
You're definitely going to get a hangover if you do that.
All right. Let's do it.
Look at that. So, of course, whilst in New York or whilst living near New York or in New York, you got to do Emmett's. Of course, Emmett's on Grove. Emmett's on McDougal. The original is still my favorite.
That's my baby. That's my favorite, too.
And there you go. New Haven versus New York City.
Oh, one last question.
Yeah. Yes.
Now that we know you and there's always a line and a wait, will you get us in?
Yeah.
Yes. Nice.
Don't do that.
Why?
Because off the air.
Okay.
Okay.
I just want to put them on.
We're no more special than anyone else. Are there any New Haven pies that you love?
I like modern pizza.
Modern is good.
Yeah, right. Modern's my favorite. You know, it's not that far from New York, and you know, I think for especially starting out, I would just, you know, try to, you know, get out and see as many pizzas as I could, and you know, there's like, you know, Frank Pepe's, Sally's, and Modern.
Right.
So I tried them all, and I like Modern.
That's where I learned how to love clam pie.
The clam pie, yeah.
Now, you don't like clam pies, don't lie.
I'm talking pizza.
Oh, sorry.
I think Zuppardi's up there is also amazing. I don't think it's in technically New Haven, but it's right there.
You've hit every single pizza place known to man. But what about people that say I have the number
one? That's the nice thing about the limo. You just can kind of cruise around. And
the limo goes right through the easy pass.
Yeah.
Hey, so a lot of people say the number one pizza in New York is actually in Jersey City. Have you been over there to have those?
Raza?
Yeah.
I have been there. Yeah, I have. I like it. You know, okay. I'm more of a tavern style pizza guy, so it's hard for me to, you know, say anything other than this is my favorite. But
I think the first pie I had sort of like yours is at Lee's Tavern over in Staten Island.
Yeah. Yeah. Really that's a special place.
It is. Mm. It is. Look, thank you for coming in.
Thank you for having me. This is a lot of fun.
Well, thanks for being had, Emmett.
Yeah.
And Emmett's, of course, on Grove, Emmett's on McDougal. You gotta pick. Why is everyone giggling?
I don't know, it's just so funny.
You want to get more pizza.
Okay.
Wrap it up.
There's like, shut up.
Everyone's trying to like eat between talking. It's not easy.
Okay, I'm telling you right now, today, wherever you are, get pizza. Thank you.
Elvis Duran.
Who the f*** likes these things?
Why don't you have a piece of bread and maybe you'll calm down a little?
And the morning show.
Z100 Summer Bash is back. Starring Teddy Swims. Free summer show returns to Hudson Yards August 8th.
It's so beautiful, right? Look at this.
Also featuring Shaboozy.
Everybody at the bar can tip.
With Bia, Mark Amber, Alex Warren, and more. Hey, did we mention that it's free? Just show up to turn up for the hottest hit makers of the summer. Cut the Line passes all this weekend to Z100 Summer Bash.
New York's number one hit music station.
Z100, we love you guys so much.
Sponsored by NissanUSA.com.
Danielle's entertainment report is sponsored by the Raycatina Auto Group. It's time to experience the all-new 2024 Lexus GX SUV at Raycatina Lexus. Redesigned for 2024, it's got everything you've come to expect from Lexus and so much more. See the new GX at Raycatina Lexus of Monmouth, Freehold, Larchmont, and White Plains.
Start your morning like us with DeLonge.